Oh, howdy, guys. Welcome back to another episode of Legend of Zelda The Minish Cap. This is Lightning Cloud 224. And the last episode, we traversed the Kessler Wilds and the Wind Ruins. In this episode, we're going to start off by taking the leftmost path. Inside the cliff whole time. Yeah, it was. Still, there might be traps in here. I don't care about traps, because, quite frankly, I'm too smart to fall in traps. Or am I? We'll find out. These guys. This'll take care of you. Come on, stop jumping around. But yeah, with the cannon pots, you can blow their head right off. Anyway, if you knock an enemy down there, they respawn, so be careful about that. Doesn't count as a death in that case. I wonder if we can shoot it. Yes, we can. Oh, yeah. Obviously, the door shut behind us. It's not good. Come on. Yeah, I recommend the boomerang and sword for this fight. Because it just stun him and hit him, and so on and so forth. Plus, you're going to need the boomerang in here anyway. Yep, all for 1 rupee. Yes, I did that. Yes, I did. Come here. Give me your red rupee. And here we go. Obviously, we can do something with these walls at some point, but we will have to wait to find out what that really is. Now, yeah. You want your arrows again. Failing at arrow shooting. And, yep. That's how you fail at shooting arrows. Ooh, puzzle! I wonder. I wonder. Ugh. Tedious arrow shooting is tedious. And here we have the compass. Now we have a better idea where we're going, or maybe. And here we go through here. Come on. Now this is quite an interesting little puzzle. First off, start with a column of two links. Push this as far as it can go. And don't forget to push that back. Then you split. That's even a word. It probably isn't. And then make a row of them. And push it up. And whenever you're done pushing, you're ready to grab this lever, pull it all the way back, and ooh, a key. I want the key. I want the key. I'm gonna jump down and get the key. Let's go! Defy gravity! Oh no, I'm gonna splat! Nope, I'm fine. And moving on, now we can go to the right side of this middle part. You could go over here, but you accomplish nothing because you can't get anywhere. This room, we're going to see this room a couple times, unfortunately. And a blue kinstone piece, and we can open the door by grabbing this one. Now that, I think, will spawn something. Oh, yes, it does. Another blue kinstone piece. It's going to be very helpful. After this dungeon, we're going to do some fusions. But until then, we'll... You climbing some ladders and... you spiky choo-choos are annoying. Come to me. Come to me, fairy. Thank you. Down here, this room. I don't even need to kill you. Come on, just chase me. Chase me. Come on. There we go. Now he's out of the way, and we can just walk on over with our double links. And fail at it. Let's try that again, shall we? Yeah, if your splits hit anything, they will dematerialize after a few seconds. So be careful what you brush up against with your extra links. Because you could be exposing the weakest link. Yes, I'm that corny. Turn that one off to be mean, and that one on because I have to. And let's diminish and come on up and come here. Just get out of the way. Fine. We're gonna be that way. Now, I recommend reminishing and jumping down. First, I'll ignore that key for the moment because there's something much more valuable here. See? A piece of heart. And we have completed a new heart container. And now we can grab it on our way back. And we have, well, we have those. We can do pretty much whatever we want, but we will go through the center, grab some hearts, even though we didn't need them, and four of you. That's my efficient way of getting rid of these guys. Boomerang and slash slash. But we're going to have to put away that boomerang because we need to shoot stuff. Even though it's completely off screen, we were able to kill a statue. If you want, you can shoot them both. That's my preference. I just like to kill them both. But now we'll have the dungeon map. So now we could check the dungeon map if we want to. I don't feel like it. And we're going to take the rightmost path, because this will take us to the item of the dungeon. And we'll explore the other path on the next part. And yeah, don't linger here too long, see? Because that guy is going to come down and try and grab you. Yeah, if you go anywhere near that door, it looks too suspicious, doesn't it? That's because it is. I recommend the bombs. I always get hit. And that was glitchy. I did not want. I'm glad I didn't have to warp. Yeah, in here we just, as you can see, we run around in a circle. And you could try the idea of taking damage to save time here. It doesn't work. Actually, takes about the same amount of time I checked. There's the super speeding goodness. Until we get a better bomb, actually. Lol, spoiler. We're gonna get a better bomb. And now we have the item of the dungeon, the mole mitts. And I think I could show you what they do. Pretty self-explanatory. They're for digging. Any of these little strange little walls or etc. can be digged. Can be dug into. Alright, I guess what we'll do is we're gonna finish our journey right about here. And on the next part, we'll explore the rest of this dungeon. And I'll check to see if you remember that I was hiding behind here. So, I guess then, thanks guys.